मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज अस्थि शरीर। सो अस्थि शरीर नॉर्मली बी डायरेक्टली कोरिलेटेड विद बोन्स एंड द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ बोन्स इन द क्लासिकल संहिताज एंड बुक्स, बट देयर इज लिटिल बिट डिफरेंसेस। इन फर्स्ट स्लाइड एक्चुअली वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट देम ओनली। द क्लासिकल वे ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग अस्थि इज अ बिट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द प्रेजेंट कंटेम्प्रेरी साइंसेस। अस्थि कैनॉट बी मेयरली कोरिलेटेड विद बोन्स एज इट इज डन हैबिचुअली। Concept of Ayurveda explain asthi in more profound meanings and cover a large number of structures other than bones. Due to difference in principle and thought of what is called asthi, there are certain other differences also, especially in enumeration of them. So actually we are going to talk about asthi here, and asthi has a bigger scope, bigger meaning, and it combines different structures which are hard in consistency. So let's see what we are going to see. So first of all, it is a hard substance which remains even after most part of body has been decayed. Asyate iti asti. Then a very important slok comes here. Tasmas chir vinashtesu tang masesu saririnam asthininam vinashyati sarin itani dehinam. It means, this sloka is by Susrut, it means it is a substance which remains even after other all parts of the body like flesh, muscles, blood vessels, etc. are shattered, even after burying the body after death. It is the last remain identity of the person even after demise. That's why it is also known as Sarani Dehinam. This is the framework of the body. So this is a very wide definition. If anybody has seen whatever is left after burying or after the burning of the dead bodies, you will see there are not only the bones, there are many bones, then there are hard cartilages also, some teeth are also left out. So everything, whichever is hard, whichever is left after the decay of other part of the body will be come under the heading of asthi. That's why the number increases. There are certain other definitions also which we are going to follow, but basic meaning will be always same. Like according to Sabda, it is the part of body which remains till long period even after the death of the body, and heart is its synonym. According to Hala Yuskos, it is the substance of body which remains till last and is in the whole body. Vasa abhyantara asti hard iti asate chipte yat asti. Means you can see meanings are same. Then this is why Pratyaksha Sariram, a little modern version. Asthi is the hard and stable dhatu which gives support to the mass, pesi and snayu. Istiram kathin avalambam dhatu sariras yata patibandete mass, pesi anta snayavascha. Means they have actually given meaning towards the bone side only. So basically we can see what is asthi. Asthi is the everything which is hard in the structure and which remains even after the decay of other soft part of the body, or even after the burying and burning the things out. That's why the meaning becomes bigger. Now what are the synonyms? Certain synonyms are used here: kikas for heart and firm, kulyam for bone, kapal skull, cranium skull bone, astri not feminine masculine structure, medojam which is produced from the medha. Before starting asthi, we have to understand what is asthi dhatu. So as we go from the one dhatu to the like rasat raktam tato mansam mansam medam tata asthi. So asthi is from that particular point of view asthi dhatu. The dhatu, the tissue, humoral systems of the body, they are always formed in a fixed sequence. In a different permutations and combinations, the dhatus from various physical organs of the body according to the genetically coded systems. It is one of the seven dhatus, as I have said already. Form of the dhatu is present inside the mass known as asthi, and then the asthi, from asthi it will be majja. It is a sequential things. What is the panchabhautik constitution? As that we know, everything is panchabhautik, but asthi has the predominance of prithvi and vayu mahabhut. Asthi has predominance of prithvi and vayu mahabhut, though that's why it has the qualities of both of things. Like as per the quality of prithvi mahabhut, asthi is strong and heavy. As per quality of vayu mahabhut, asthi is dry and rough. If you have seen the cross section of bone, you will see there are small pores are present which carries the good amount of vayu. Okay, and bone itself in the complete form is a very hard and heavy structure. So both of them are in dominant format, though it is made up of all five things. So what are the qualities which they are giving us? Strongness, roughness, dryness and hardness. What are the karma of asthi? So dehadharan, मज्जा पुष्टि एंड सपोर्ट साराणी देहिनम फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट श्लोक व्हाट वी हैव सीन टुडे अस्थि सपोर्ट द मास रैन स्नायु दीज आर द सर्टेन फंक्शंस ऑफ अस्थि वी आर ओनली टॉकिंग ऑन द क्लासिकल बेसिस देन अस्थि मल एवरी धातु हैज इट्स मल तो देयर आर थ्री व्यूज चरक संहिता सुश्रुत एंड भावप्रकाश यू कैन सी बेसिकली फोर थिंग्स आर द केस लूम नख एंड रोम एंड wherever they are present is plus sign is there wherever they are absent is minus is whether the author is gone for it or not like charak has gone for kesh loma both but susrut haven't gone susrut has gone for nakh and loma so you can again see nakh is a hard part loma is also little bit hard. Then comes the number if somebody is vedavagi means follower of veda basically all of us are follower of Veda only but then also the difference is the charak samhita it is 360 the susrut samhita 300 so these are two the most important 360 and 300 then they have followers like ashtang hriday ashtang sangraha and kashyap and bhela they all have 360 only susrut and bhavprakash have the 300 in total number so as susrut is more versed with the dissection he has dissected the body and then he might have counted then the number is little bit less than the 360 Then comes a distribution on the sadang basis or regional basis. So there are two views directly we get from one from Susrut Samhita and one from Ashtanga Sangraha. So Sakha it is 140, Suroni parts of Purush to Urdh it is 117, and Siro Grivo Urdhu it is 63. So in the limbs it is 140, in the trunk region it is 117, and above the head and neck or above the head and neck it is 63. In Ashtanga Sangraha it is more typical in limbs like upper limbs and lower limbs both it is 140 only directly they have given in madhya sharir 120 and urdhva sharir they have given 100 and so both the views are important especially for the PG purpose then there are types in Ayurveda are basically on the basis of size shape position of asthi body and they have divided to five types but you can see these actually five types themselves are one of the basis for the division Okay, like first of all there is Kapala Asthi which is given by all you can see everybody has gone for these five Veda only yeah, whether it is Susrut, Ashtanga, Ashtanga Hridaya or Bhava Prakasa then Ruchak, then Tarun, then Valaya, then Nalak we'll talk in detail about them also so what does each type means so Kapala Asthi they are flat in nature literally means the bone or the hard structure which covers and protects the cranial cavity or brain Valaya Asthi they are round in shape or hemicircle in shape Tarun Asthi they are soft in nature literally it means either they haven't developed fully that is they haven't completed their ossification or they are in the process of going towards the ossification like in the bones of developing chariots Nalika Asthi is long tube like structure they are reed shape and then come a very specific division which actually nowadays is not considered a type of Asthi, that is Ruchak Asthi, the bones which are different from all and utilized to chew the food and enjoy the taste. They are for taste sensation. The Ruchak Asthi is specifically for the teeth only. So basically, in classical basis, there are five types: Kapala, Valaya, Tarun, Nalak, and Ruchak Asthi. And then you can see their locations. Also. The locations I have comprised from different books also, like Kapala Asthi. Basically present in Janu, Nitam, Amps, Gand, Talu, Sankh, Pankshana and Madhya Sarir means wherever the flat type of bones are present. Valaya Asthi in Pani, Pad, Uru, Parshu, Prishth like vertebrates, like ribs. So these are things that some commentators don't agree with this as they count other bones here also like these are present in Griva and Prishtha also. Tarun Asthi are specially present in the Ghran, Karn, Griva and Akshipud. So you can see these are specially the cartilages ring like structures which are present here bhoja has also included kantha in this rest the tractor rings might be in the thought of that so he has also included the tarona here then comes the nalaka whatever we have talked till now we are going to delete it or minus then whatever is left it will come under this so commentator like dalton and bhoja has given some specified bones also like hasta anguli padatal kurch babu asti Janga Asthi etc. is the example. So these are the typical examples of Nalak Asthi. Especially you can simply understand the bones of limbs. Then come Ruchak Asthi. These are dasanta, that is teeth. They are 28 or 32 in number. all that are regularly regarded as asthi along with various different parts of stem. So due to the definition of asthi, which is more profound, more bigger, that everything which is heart is included here. That's why we are seeing the Tarun Asthi type also here. We are seeing Ruchak type also here. Then there is a charted formation of the Sankhya and name, especially due to the Charak, like Danta 32, Dant Ulukula 32, Nakha 20, Anguliya 60, Salaka 20. Then likewise their names are given, especially Jangha, you can see they are 4 in number, Kapalika 2 in number, Throni Phalak 2 in number, very important, Throni Phalak 2 in number, Bhagasthi 1, then Prishtagat Asthi 45, Griva 15, Jatru 1, Sankha 2, Sira Kapal 4. Whatever name I have taken, they might be a little bit more important, but you should go through all the charts. Then we are going to talk about Sushrut. So here you can see the number is less, so something they have combined or they have deleted it. So you can see here Anguliya 60 and Kul and Kuch, they have combined it 20, Jangha it is 8, Throni it is 5, important Throni it is 5, Prashta they are 30, Griva they are 9, Hanu 2, Danta 32, then Ganda 2, Karna 2, Sankha 2 and Sira 6, the total becomes 300. So at least you should correlate both the charts and try to identify the differences if they are occurring, like the difference in the, you can see the difference in the Throni, then you can see in the Sira. So like this you should go through it. These are certain charts and their classical names are written here, so you should try to learn some classical names also along with the modern names of the bones. So that's all for this very small topic. Normally it comes for 4 marks question. If it comes for longer version, then they are also asking some bone in a detail also. So the basic thing, first of all, you should know asthi is not equivalent to bone. There is some difference due to the broader definition of the classical text. Then the number 300 and 360, then there are subdivisions region wise, and then we have to talk about the bone types. There are 5 types. Basically, if you see on the size basis, on the ossification basis, and one very much separate specific function, that is Ruchak Asthi. And then we have to learn a little bit about the names of the bone and their number also. So that's all for today.